everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another example today where we convert polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates. In this example, our polar coordinate is the point negative 2 comma 2 pi over 3. So whenever you're converting polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates, you're going to be using these two formulas here. Our polar point here represents r comma theta. In other words, negative 2 is r, and 2 pi over 3 is theta. The point is r theta, just like a Cartesian point would be x comma y. So these are the two formulas we're going to be working with to convert the polar point to a Cartesian point, or the polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates. X equals r cosine theta, and y equals r sine theta. So from these two formulas, when we plug in negative 2 for r into both of these formulas here and here, and when we plug in 2 pi over 3 for theta here and here, the two equations that we'll come up with are the following. X equals negative 2 cosine of 2 pi over 3, and y equals negative 2 sine of 2 pi over 3. So it's as simple as that. We're plugging in negative 2 for r and 2 pi over 3 for theta. Once we've come up with these equations here, we need to use our unit circle to evaluate cosine of 2 pi over 3 and sine of 2 pi over 3. So let's go ahead and bring up our unit circle. And what we're going to want to do is look for the point at which the angle theta equals 2 pi over 3, because we're looking for cosine of 2 pi over 3 and sine of 2 pi over 3. So we look at our unit circle and we see that here at 2 pi over 3, this is the point at which we need to evaluate our two equations here. So 2 pi over 3, and whenever you're using the unit circle, evaluating cosine of 2 pi over 3 or cosine of any angle will give you the x-coordinate here, this negative 1 half, and sine will give you the y-coordinate. So when we have x equals negative 2 cosine of 2 pi over 3, this cosine of 2 pi over 3, we look for the angle, 2 pi over 3, and then because it's cosine, we look at the x-coordinate, which is here, this negative 1 half. So we're going to get negative 2, and then this cosine of 2 pi over 3 becomes this negative 1 half, which we pulled from here on our unit circle. And then for the negative 2 sine of 2 pi over 3 equation, we're going to look at the angle 2 pi over 3 here, and then because it's sine, because we're evaluating sine, we look at the y-coordinate, which is the square root of 3 over 2. So we take the square root of 3 over 2 and replace it in place of this sine 2 pi over 3 here. So we've simplified both equations, and now we just go ahead and simplify. We have a negative 2 that can cancel with this negative 2 here, and we get a positive 1 for our x-coordinate. And then we have the 2's cancel, and we end up with a negative square root of 3 for our y-coordinate. And then for our Cartesian coordinates, we started with polar coordinates, and we're converting to Cartesian coordinates. We just take these two here, x equals 1 and y equals negative square root of 3, and put them together for our final answer. So we get the Cartesian coordinates 1 comma negative square root of 3. So I hope that helped you guys, and I will see you next time. Bye!